The two paladins Gareth mentioned are arguing in front of the door to the modest farmstead. As they notice your arrival, they stop talking and look at you quizzically.
We're guarding this house. Wise to stay well back. There's a bunch of silent monks inside who've tasted blood today. Already killed in there, so they did.
They didn't kill anybody. The magisters who controlled them did. You know Donna, she wouldn't hurt a fly. Not until they turned her.
But they did turn her. And now she's not Donna anymore. Get it through your head. The poor creature should be put down.
No, wait! Surely, maybe someday they can be fixed. When all this source nonsense is over.
The other paladin rolls his eyes and shakes his head as he turns to face you.
In any event, it's our business, not yours. You just stay well away from the door and you'll be perfectly safe. That thing isn't Donna. It isn't anybody. It's a monster, pure and simple. All of them are. Besides, what's the alternative? Guard this door forever? Feed them like pets? Get yourself together, man.
Good find.
Voidwoken! The sorcerer's conjured Voidwoken! Form up! Don't let them over the bridge!
The spectral magister raises his sword and shield against an unseen Voidwoken foe.
This magister didn't die by a sword, anyway. Something's afoot here.
Whoa. Ground's trembling almost as bad as the Lady Vengeance on rough seas. To be a grim harvest this year.
Don't worry, I'll keep watch.
This is madness. I'm having flashbacks from the Great War. The Black Ring, of course. At least they're honest about how wicked they are. The Ganglelegs have gone nuts for good this time. They're destroying the place for reasons too stupid to know. Oh, but you better grab a pair of shears. I'm not about to let you just rip it out of me, silly.
Be grateful that you don't feel the need. The statue appears almost to hide in the shadowed and leafy glade, peering out at you from behind rustling branches. The wind rises and sings. A flurry of dancing leaves weaves an esoteric pattern around your feet.
Your kind has been dismembering and burning mine since time immemorial. I must admit, the smell of charred human flesh is so very enticing. If you can find a bucket, sure, consider it my last offering to a dying race.
shambles, this. My thanks for your help.
He takes a pull from a water canteen, then splashes some over his blood-stained hands.
No, it ain't mine. A sorcerer fugitive was hiding here. Some of the locals were stupid enough to help him. We got a tip-off, but he wasn't willing to go quietly. These Voidwoken appeared, thanks to him. It was messy. A lot of the locals didn't make it, and those that did, well, there's a price for helping sorcerers.
Any trace of gratitude for your help against the Voidwoken drains away in an instant.
Take my advice and don't say another word. Hear me? Sorcerers brought this plague down on us. Them and the sort of folk who see fit to help them. They'll all get what they deserve. You can join them if you like. Otherwise, you can shut your trap. What the hell do you think it means?
He pats the pommel of his sword, his hand still tinted with dried blood. Little doubt whom it belongs to anymore.
Good choice. Now make another good choice and don't let me see you around here again.
The stench of dead Voidwoken assails you. The thought occurs, sorcerers caused this.
Tyrants will dredge up any reason to silence the people. Sure, source isn't all good, but that don't mean you can change the world order to control it either.
Nothing's all good, sure as nothing's all bad. Can't throw the whole world in Fort Joy.
Source is like life, a twin of death. The sooner the Magisters accept this, the better.
The spirit of a woman cowers before you. She has her hand clamped over her mouth in a desperate effort to stifle the whimpering. Something catches her eye. Terror swamps her, and she slips to the floor, screaming.
Help! Somebody! Help! Voidwoken!
The feet of this statue are slick and dark with oil, and spatters of Voidwoken ichor mark the ground around it. Shiny blackness drips from each toe. Your eyes close. Death's shadows lift. Rain becomes sun. Whatever fear this graveyard provoked is now bathed in brilliant light.
Second time's a charm? Or have I asked too much of you? I do hope I've not been overestimating your intelligence. Anathema's blade. By the weapon's own admission, it's to be found somewhere on Blood Moon Island.
Thank you.
Well, I'll be around and about. Second time's a charm? Or have I asked too much of you?
Keep distant. My own demons haunt me too closely. I cannot also bear the burden.
As you approach, the silent monk puff.
Traitor!